28th November, today we are taking class compiler constructions. So what we still now learn compiler construction. We have covered lexical analyzer because it is the easiest part. It is done by a finite state machine, and its only job is to get it the token first. What are the tokens? Tokens are the keywords of the token, the operators plus minus, these are the tokens, variables names of the token, and the semicolon is a token, opening braces, closing braces, all these are closed in the C language or Java, these are the tokens. So there's a stored in a symbol table, and what kind of errors it can be. So side by side, because we have more than 50% we have covered in the compiler construction class, nearly 50%. So we always, what are the errors can be generated? What could be the error? Because you know, any variable name cannot start with dollar sign. So this error would be generated in the lexical analyzer itself. But is there a missing semicolon? That cannot be generated by lexical analyzer. It will be checked by the syntax analyzer. Or if you see, if you make a illogical while loop, that is also not be connected, checked by lexical or syntax, may not be semantic analyzer, that will be a error done by the infinite while loop by the programmer. So not all errors can be approach, but you know what kind of errors in the lexical analyzer can make it. The variable name should not be maintain the proper discipline, so that it should start with not numeric and not dollar, not hyphen like this, and comment line like in forward slash star and C comment line, star forward slash is one of the star is missing, that will the role of the lexical analyzer will point you out. So, we will come to this. The error analysis is one of the fundamental things. So, any compiler should have good error analysis so that it get back and it will help you the programmers to find error. We will discuss a little bit about of error analysis last in earlier class, and we also discuss today, we try to discuss the fast and follow function of variables. It come on strange. What is fast and follow function? Fast and follow function, we will come to that. For any, you know, your programming language needs context free grammar. Without context free grammar, you cannot program. Why? Because the only context free grammar give you the opening braces and closing braces match and if then else support, because your regular language cannot give this if then else support and opening braces and closing braces. So, because you need to call function again and again recursion, so you need a context free grammar. If you have a context sensitive grammar, that will be much helpful, but context sensitive grammar, we already know that the parsing, it will be NP complete, so that sometimes your compilation may come quickly, sometimes may not. So, we want that our compilation should be in linear time, not only linear time, polynomial time, not only polynomial time, it should be linear time, it should be O n, not O n cube. Like all context free grammar, theoretically bounded, it can be shown that any, if you can design a good parser for any context free grammar with O n cube. But we have some limitations in the programming language. We all know that our parsing tree or abstract syntax tree, you know what is the difference between parsing tree and abstract syntax tree. I have gone into detail. It should be unique. So whether you go from left to right or right to left, your parsing tree should be unique. So that is called unambiguous grammar. And you also know a language can have many grammars, and you cannot, and to check the one grammar is equivalent to another grammar, this is also, there is no algorithm for it, and context free grammar, that is really a strange case. So, we by hitch and hike or by somehow we have to find a grammar which is unambiguous, then we can say the language is unambiguous. A language can have ambiguous grammar and unambiguous grammar also, but for programming language we always fix the unambiguous grammar. If any question, any time if you have, please tell your microphone and ask me the question. I am open to any question from whatever we have covered, or if we wish to cover in the next few classes, you can. I am also recording your offline classes also, I will give them. So this is online class. Don't hesitate to call me at any time. Just, sir, I am not understanding this. I can go back. Okay. So that is the beauty of the context-free grammar. Then we context-free grammar in sometimes in the opening session we go details about the Chomsky's normal form. Chomsky's normal form says the left hand side is the single variable, right hand side two variable or single terminal. But that is very uninteresting for any programming languages. Your programming languages should support if then else, while, do. So it cannot be limited only two variables or single terminal. So Chomsky's normal form is for theoretical interest for some other purpose, but it is not useful that way in a programming language framework. Moreover, programming language framework, it needs, you need quick parsing. The parsing can be done from left to right or right to left. From left to right, we have to match the terminal, and then it will be helpful if the all your rules start with a different terminal, that like ace grammar. But ace grammar is too simplistic. Ace grammar is say left hand side should start with a single terminal and all variables. It's basically ace grammar is that way. You cannot design it in programming languages. Okay, so thing is that it should be started in a separate terminal, but it can start with a variable also. If a variable starts with another variable, then another it starts with variable in two cases. Say S starts with A one rule and another is S starts with S. That is a recursion. So the recursion has to be avoided for the top down parsing. So that can be removed. We have discussed the all left recursion can be removed. And then it might be a fit case for top down, but it is not guaranteed. So we have other techniques for this. We will calculate the first function and follow function. What is first function? Say all the variables. First means if we calculate first of a any variable or terminal, so it will occur first. The first of a terminal is always a terminal because terminal cannot vanish. First of a variable, if the variable go to the epsilon, the first of is can be epsilon. Okay. If first of a variable rule is like S is equal to a big variable B, then first of S is small a. So if, that means the first of any variable is whichever terminal, a sets of terminal which can you can expect with. You can expect with. That is first, and follow is any variable which you can see at the end of it. Like a start variable, the end is the in dollar sign. Now, if we think the all the string of terminals ends with a dollar sign. So follow of s is dollar is always. So this first we'll calculate, and for we'll see that the all the first of the all variables, if it is disjointed, so say then it will be a case fit case for LL1 grammar. We'll see today if possible. Okay, so let's start, and you ask any question. We'll a little bit discuss whatever you have done, and then we'll go for this error analysis, and we'll already started first and follow, and we'll try to make a table, and the table the tops will be the your terminals, and left hand side should be variables. So all variables with one terminal, there should be one and only one rule. If you can make this kind of table, this parsing tables it is called, and these are there are only one and only rule in one box. Left hand side, remember, left hand side the variable, all variables, and top side will be the terminals. Then it is a guaranteed case of LL1 parsing table. Then you can say it can be a LL1 table. LL1 is one of the best parsing. Even our Python 3.9 version can have the LL1. LL1 is a very good parsing technique. It is easiest, and then better is LR1, and that will take more complex. So first thing is you have to go for first and follow for all the variables and make a parsing table and see that all the boxes have only one and only rule. We'll see to that because this is our target today. Okay. So, lexical analyzer we have covered, then syntax analyzer we are in the 50% we have covered, because the top down parsing techniques, the first function, follow function and this parsing table, it will be used in the our bottom up parsing also. And this is a abstract syntax tree, and then the semantic analyzer. Semantic analyzer checking will be whether you have put float into int or int into float without casting operator, without casting, these things will be checked by the semantic analyzers, semantic analyzer. Okay. This we have already covered. The, we are basically in the context free grammar and deterministic context free grammar. Yes, we already covered. Let's quickly go to the today our content. Please have patience. Yes. Are you getting everyone? Please, can anyone put microphone on? Yes. This is the errors, the kinds of errors. Probably we have covered in the little bit of class, little bit of in last class. The errors are the compile time and the run time. So, runtime error we are not, because we are a compiler class, runtime we are not discussing. Runtime can be many types, it may be CPU error, it may be memory error, maybe power error, all these things, it cannot be, it can be handled by the operating system itself. And the compile type, the lexical phase error that we have already discussed, like misspelling identifier, keyword or operator. Syntactic error is determined at the parsing area, is the arithmetic expression with unbalanced parentheses. Yes, this kind can come up here. Some of the questions might be asked, the unbalanced parentheses, which stage it will be. It will not be lexical, it will be syntactic. Semantics, operators applied to incompatible operand. So, whether your operands are okay for the operation, this will not be checked at the syntax analyzer. Please mind it. And logical, infinitely recursive call, this cannot be checked by the compiler, but there are some advanced compiler might be there which can help you, but these are the advanced compiler. They may take the machine intelligence or machine learning technique they can use for this compiler. Yeah. The error handler is a parser, is a simple to state calls. It should report the message of errors clearly and accurately. Yes, because it, then it can detect errors and it recovers it quickly, so that yes, and it is definitely all these things. Is it visible to you all? Anyone please speak, please. Sometimes one of two questions is most welcome. So, whatever we are covering, are you getting me? And one or two questions is welcome. I am waiting for one question. Any question, even comments will do. Any question, please. Anyone? Yes. This is lexical phase errors. This, all these notes will be given to you. This is, you know, this, yeah, this is self-evident. I have told you this is a comment. So, comment line should be forward slash star. So, this can be lexical phase, it can be done. And there is common technique one should know, what is the panic mode recovery. Panic mode recovery is whenever there is lots of errors are coming, you know, in compiler, if you make in language, if you make a single error, that error may creep into others errors. So, you have to come out the compiler and it should have some synchronizing token. This is the, this terms will come to you again and again. What are the synchronizing tokens in your programming languages? Generally, they are taken with the semicolon or the this this thing closing braces till that the compiler is sane, they are, and the other are taken as a, they are the synchronizing token, they are chosen, so that anything after that they leave it and they found it, and whatever the errors they report it. Syntactic phase errors is error in structure, missing operator, misspelled keywords, yes, unbalanced parentheses. This is the errors in there. You might ask whether it can be why not in lexical stage, but lexical stage it might not find. Okay, it may be syntax it will find. So these are the recovery technique. Panic mode is always whenever a compiler goes to certain stage, they quickly panic mode, and the last synchronizing token is a semicolon or bracket. Global correction is very advanced compiler. I'll come to this. Semantic errors, yes. Incompatible types of operands, yes. I have already said undeclared variables. See, undeclared variables is comes into the semantic errors. It depends on language to language. In C language, it's not as possible. It will be always maybe at the say simple program. It can be at the syntax before lexical analysis itself, but sometimes the variable may be in header file or global variable, maybe it may be a semantic error also, it checked at this place. Symbol table you have already covered, then we will go to the first function and little bit of parsing where you are, just be patient. These things we have already covered, yes. Just a minute. Yeah, these things also cover just this is very important thing. This is very important. This note will be given to you, don't worry. This is the top down parsing. The top down parsing is the easiest one. Top down can be also two types. One is it back and forth, like it go back and come and again. So there also you find it is the left recursive production. See, this is A to A alpha, that is A left hand side also A, right hand side also A. This is not allowed in top down because it will go to infinite recursion. So this has to be eliminated. How to make it? A to A alpha, you make it A to beta R, and R to you take a new variable R. A to beta R, R can go to epsilon and alpha R. So these two rules now change to three rules. Are you getting? This is a elimination of left recursive production. So if you find any context free grammar with a left recursion, what is left recursion? See, if you see this variable here, it is direct recursion. You can see the variable here also, that is direct recursion. This is, if any question comes to it, whether it is you can top down parsing? No way. Top down parsing, top down LL1, it cannot be, no way. And also, it is not recommended for back and forth because it can go to the infinite loop. So, top down parsing, you can remove the rule. So, you have to modify the rules this way, like A to you take a new variable R. So this is, you can see the basically rules are same, A to beta R, R and to alpha R, and the basically two rules are said. So this is a removal of left recursion, and this can be generalized. So then you can, then it can be a fit for the top down, but it is not guaranteed. Guaranteed can be only be done whenever we will make a parsing table. The parsing table will call every square, that is left hand side a variable, top is any terminal, any variable, any terminal, there are only one and only one rule, then you can say it can be LL1 parsing. There will be no back and forth and it can be guaranteed O in time. We will come to this. Elimination of left recursion, so that I have mentioned. Whenever you see this is the new rule. If you find this kind of rule A to A alpha, then you make this rule, new variable A dash. Yeah, this is which of the rule, this is a question, which of these rule of the question, which of the rule is, which of the following is true for left recursive grammar? See, if you follow, don't take the this one A. It generates ambiguous grammar. It cannot be said that bottom up parser does not decode the left recursive grammar. You cannot say that. Not so not it causes recursive descent to loop forever. This is the reason A. Okay, this one. Left factoring, that means to remove left recursion, you have the remedy is left factoring. So, that is the, this kind of grammar creates a problematic situation. So, what is left factoring? This is the like every rule starts with A, we make this rule like this one. A dash, we make a new variable and make this rule. Let us go more details. Yes. You see this rule S to ITS is the same thing, it comes. So, what we can do, we can take a this S is equal to S dash A and S dash equal to ES, and this is the rule. This is a little bit complex. I will try to find more easier rules. So, two rules change to incorporate another variable S dash, and by doing this you can see that there is no confusion. Here is a left factoring because I comes here, I comes here. So, you are confused top down parsing which rule to use. So, left factoring remove this only if the string comes with I, then it fired this rule only, not but here in the, if two rules are given. So, they try with this one first, then this one first. This is back and forth, that is top down parsing, that will take a inordinate time, but for LL1 parsing we should have every rule should start with a different terminal or variable. It should not start with say A starts cannot start with S, then it is a it's all over loop. So, this for top down parsing top down parsing for where it is brute force top down parsing, this may be done, but not which is good top down like recursive descent or LL1. LL1 is the best, that will guaranteed the O(n) time. It should start with different terminal or different variable, but that is not guaranteed. Ultimately, we have to create a parsing table. The how to create that parsing table, we try to cover that. Any question at any time, please, or any past issues you can raise. Am I audible? Anyone can please speak. Please, anyone, mic on and speak that I am audible, because I am taking the full screen. There is the presentation is visible or not? Please. Anyone? Any confusion? You please tell. And last class, the recording, I unfortunately not there. Let's see. So, this is I am recording. So, the video I am recording here, I will try to give today itself. Yes, this is you see the rules is like this, it is not good for LL1. So, we have to modify the rule like here, we modify this rule this way. So, then it will be then two versions. So, now after this you can see the there is no such recursion, and it will every left hand side, right hand side, all the rules have starts with a new terminal or not the same variable. So, you have to modify the rule left, this is called left factored grammar. Let us see other examples. There are lots of examples, I will give all it to you today itself. Important one I cover. Yeah, then the compilation fast and follow. Here you see the very simple two rules, this CAD and A is equal to BC and A. So, what is first of S? The first of S is nothing but C. Okay. First of terminal is always a terminal, first all you have to calculate first of all variables, first of S is C, and first of A is it can be B or it can be A, not C. Okay. So, whenever a simple string CAD. So, we already know first of S is C and first of A is B or A. So, whenever you see C, so if you see the LL1 parsing, so we must select the S CAD, and then we see the Next is A, and then which rule to find. So, BC or A. We found A, so we take this rule. So, it will be the computer that way very stupid. It is, it cannot see, we can see the rules on our hand, everything, but computer have to pre-calculate. They calculate the first of all variables and they try to match the left hand side, which one they matches. If it matches two rules, then there will be conflict and LL1 parsing will not be there. LL1 is the best parsing. So, we have to calculate, we have to all variables first function and the follow function. We'll, what is first I have already explained, but little bit technically we will do it here. And why follow? Follow is required because follow is the which terminals which comes after this variable, that is follow, that will also required. Any question, please? Okay, this is I have told how to first set. If any if it's a terminal, definitely that will be terminal. If x epsilon in the production rule, then epsilon to be added to first. So we are calculating first of a variable, not terminal, because first of a terminal is always a terminal. First of a variable, if variable goes to epsilon, then epsilon is added to first x. If variables goes to y1, y2, y3, then you have to go first of x is equal to first of y1. Okay. If y1 first of x is equal to y1, yes. If first y1 contains epsilon, then first of x is equal to first of y1 minus epsilon union of first of y2. If all goes to epsilon, then you can include epsilon in your first of x. This is tricky part. If x is consist of y1, y2, y3, if all y1, y2, y3 goes to epsilon, then only you can include epsilon to the first of x. If the epsilon contains in y1, then it will be first of y2. Okay. If it epsilon contains y2, then first of y3. If all can this go to epsilon, then you can use the epsilon to the first of x. So, you then see these two production rules of this grammar. Just check these rules. For see here, every rule starts with a different terminals or variables. So, there is no left recursion. Another way, right recursion can be there, there will be no problem for sender. The left recursion should not be there for the not there for the top down parsing. Left recursion can be there for LR1 parsing. Okay, we have not covered that, but left recursion is absolutely no for top down parsing. For top down parsing, we are discussing only LL1 parsing, not the brute force top down parsing. Brute force top down parsing can solve any parsing problem, but the timing will not be O(n) cube. Timing might be O(n) cube. That is unacceptable. So, we are whatever the top down parsing limitation are, that there should not be this E cannot becomes here. So, the no recursion. Okay. And another thing you will see that the your parsing table should have a unique entry. So, first check that here by seeing the rules that is the computer can say they all start with a different terminals or variable. So, we just calculate first of B. First of E is what is the first of E? It will be first of T. Yeah, first of T. First of T is what is the first of T? Comes here. First of T. First of F. First of F comes these opening braces. Okay, so opening braces or ID. So the first of E, the set is first is opening braces or ID. Similarly, first of E dash is a plus and epsilon. If you see the E dash here, E dash first of E dash is plus is there. Yes, plus is there. E dash and anywhere E dash is there. E dash must go to epsilon at some place. Yeah, because E dash can go to epsilon. So, first of E dash is first plus and epsilon. Similarly, the first set is calculated. So, this is the calculation of the first set. So you today any question, you are most welcome today, because all those things I am making an offline recording, already made it and all clear details, because online there is a requirement. I will cover this. Please, I have this forum is open for any question, any question. And now I am expecting a Google Meet of your individual small projects on compiler constructions. Some of you have expressed interest, you can ask any topic, whichever is covered, and whichever is not covered also you can take it. Please, questions, and ask me any question, any one of you. I am ending my presentation right now, and any question, please give me the question. Yes, Devapriyo, Anik, Krishna, stop sharing. Who are there? Anupam, any question? Krishna, Devolina, Devolina, Gyandeep, what? Any question, please? You give your roll numbers, okay, good. Any question? Am I audible? Yes, please, question. I should be visible right now. Any question, please? I think after a long time, you can make one of two microphone on. It will be helpful for me. Devapriyo, you are giving attendance. Don't go, I am not going to this, please. You ask question, I will be more happier. Orijit, Anupam, Ashutosh, Vishal, Devarati, any question? Devolina, question? Devapriyo, or you just comment something. Devraj, I will be happier. Ditipriya, Gopal, Gyandeep, Kaustav, Kaustav, please make your mic on, please, Kaustav.
Yes, sir.
Question karo ekta. Are, khali shunei jaccho. Question.
Sir, any question.
Any question. Any question.
Sir, bolchilam je LL1 or LL0, don't difference
ki. Good question. Eita bhalo question korche. LL0 hocche as stupid, because keu tumi jodi dekhte na pao. হ্যাঁ, তুমি যদি একটা স্টেপও দেখতে না পাও, তুমি কিছুই করতে পারবে না। মানে জিরো আর ওয়ানে এখানে ডিফারেন্সটা ইনফাইনাইট। হ্যাঁ, ইউ হ্যাভ টু বি LL1। এখন তুমি বলতে পারো স্যার LL1 এর থেকে LL2 তো বেটার। ইয়েস, LL2 বেটার, কিন্তু LL1 ক্যান ডু অল দ্য থিংস, ওকে, লাইক ইউর টুরিং মেশিন। ইউর টুরিং মেশিন ক্যান স্টেপ অনলি সি, স্টেপ অনলি প্লাস ওয়ান আর মাইনাস ওয়ান, ইজ এ ডিফারেন্ট এক্সাম্পল, বাট LL0 will not be ফিটেড অ্যাট অল। So LL0 cannot be a technique. So in never any book you find a LL0 grammar. LL0 means you cannot look ahead. If you cannot look ahead, so why I am making all my production rules, the right hand side rule should start with a different terminal or a variable. For what for? Because I am top down parsing, I am trying to match my ultimate terminals with this rules. So I must look at least one, at least one. If it is two, I can quickly select which rule. Okay, are you getting?
Yes, sir.
So one is okay. If it is two, definitely more powerful. So you can see two symbols, then you can select which rule to fire. So if it starts with the same terminals, say one rule starts with A B, and another rule starts with A C. So if you can look ahead two, then you can find a AB, so I can take the AB rule. So in all cases, LL1 or LL2, LR1 or LR2 are more powerful than the other. Like LL2 is more powerful than LL1, but LL0 has no power. Same comes to LR, LR2, LR. So are you getting my point? But LR is a difficult parsing technique. But if you have to understand first and follow function for top down parsing, so that it will be parsing table. Parsing table If left hand side should be the variables and top side will be the terminals, and every variable and every terminal should match with one and only rule by looking at the first. So that is the thing. Good question. Any such question, it might trivial, but you please ask the question. Otherwise, class is this online class is basically foolish and no use. This is a you can stress buster type. Devolina, host of welcome. You can ask more question. If others don't ask the question, you ask. আর কে কে আছে? দেবময়, অনন্যা, আস্ক কোশ্চেন, অনন্যা, অমৃত, কাদের কাদের দেখতে পাচ্ছি? দেবলীনা তো কথাই বলছে না, অরিয়েত্রী আছে নাকি? নিশা, নিশা এনি কোশ্চেন? শিবাঙ্গী প্লিজ কোশ্চেন, নিশা মাইক অন প্লিজ, নিশা মাইক অন, আই দেখ You are there, I believe.
Yes.
Yes. Any question, please, Nisha. Any question. Anything on compiler. Anything. Compiler is not easy. It is not easy, and in online it's much tougher. But I am trying my level best. You just ask any question. Like Kostav has a very relevant question. Good question. You can ask any question on compiler. You can ask from why compiler we are learning. You can ask that basic question also. Most welcome. Nisha, what about the assignment topic? Acha Kaustav, are you getting me?
Yes, sir.
You please choose any topic, any interesting topic within your syllabus, and then we will make a presentation with 9 on 10, and within next week we will go for all presentation 1:1. And
topic
any topic with 5 gate questions. Okay, first of all a topic, and you try to search and find 5 gate question, gate level, and each gate question you answer. So that is the preparation. Not go for mark out, you can go for gate or similar type of question all over the, you can see this, and you can take the say any subtopic. Say you can take LR1, LLR1, SLR1, or go for the top down parsing LL1 and go for fast follow, or there's a error, the panic mode recovery. There are lots of topics are there. I have to abstract syntax tree, but these are already I have covered. So you can take newer topic, go to your syllabus, you can take any topic, take 5 solved questions and try to understand the things, compiler this thing, because we have already little covered analysis portion, not synthesis portion. Synthesis is code generation, code modification. So you can take the topic from there also. So